Greetings, fellow authors. Welcome back to the Winter Fools. Today's mission at hand is Operation Snowblind. And I suppose that the title is sort of self-explanatory. The objective is simply to destroy a satellite uplink facility, which essentially will disable the comms and hopefully take the nukes out of the game until a latter point in time as well, since, you know, the nukes are pretty much, you know, they rely on satellite communications. But I suppose handling the nukes themselves, we'll get to that at the very end of this campaign, which will also be the end of this game. And I can't exactly look back at it and say that I have not enjoyed it. But anyway, that's a topic for the last video. I digress at this point. We'll get to it when we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Right now, let's go ahead and check out this mission. The map seems rather straightforward, thankfully. And, well, at least, you know, the patrol part seems straightforward, not the patrol part, the objective part. There are two green squares here. I don't know if they're the objectives or they're the bunkers. Because I think in one of the Uzbekistan missions, the bunkers were recorded in green. Then they were not, in fact, the objectives, which was a little misleading anyhow. Yeah, mission. Destroy the enemy's primary satellite uplink facility designated objective Osiris. Execution. Black Widow will insert you into the hills northwest of objective Osiris, approximately 25 meters southeast. From your insertion point, you will come to a broad valley. Directly across the valley, approximately 600 meters away, objective Osiris sits atop a mountain. Your axis of advance will take you across the valley, next to the western edge. Use the rough terrain to your advantage. Yeah, I probably can use it for cover. Let's see though. I mean, thus far I can only see, like, sparse patrol on the outskirts. Not much by way of, you know, dense population, but you never know how these things go, especially with the winter setting and then snowstorms all over the place. I imagine getting proper satellite reconnaissance or, you know, aerial reconnaissance would be difficult. Anyway, moving on. Your axis of advance will take you across the valley next to the western edge. Use the rough terrain to advantage. We have already read that. Once the satellite uplink is destroyed, you must get to your extraction point 250 meters southeast of the objective. In order for this mission to be successful, you must destroy the uplink and reach your extraction point. Expected enemy forces. Satellite imagery of the objective shows that all approach routes are covered by fortified positions. In addition, the valleys are all heavily patrolled. The satellite dish at the objective is situated on top of a large-scale bunker complex. Allied support. Alpha team will insert approximately 640 meters northwest of the objective, and Charlie team will insert approximately 640 meters northeast of the objective. So here and here, basically. Their axis of advance is planned to allow for a coordinated assault on the northern perimeter of Objective Osiris. Basically, Alpha team will be taking the bad guys out from this axis, Charlie team from this axis, if they don't die to them first, which is something which is very likely to happen. Situation. While enemy forces divided into it is time to destroy their ability to communicate with each other and the outside world. The enemy's main satellite communication center is located on Novaya Zemlya's Novaya. Now, here's the thing. I think it is spelled Novaya because, I don't know. I think it is spelled Novaya instead of Novaya. Who knows? Novaya Zemlya's highest peak. With much of the facility located within a hardened bunker designated to withstand anything but a direct hit from a nuclear weapon. Ouch! It has been decided by Joint Operations Command or Special Forces Command. That sounds a little redundant, but okay. To handle its destruction. As Spetsnaz forces are committed elsewhere, it has been decided that Delta Force will ensure the destruction of this facility. I see. I mean, in the end, everything falls down onto the Force's shoulders, doesn't it? I'll just go ahead and change the secondary weapon to the law. because, as we have discussed before, the rest of it does not work. But before I go ahead and launch this mission, let me just go ahead and confirm something.
Bravo, your target is the dish. Take out the dish.
Roger, King 6. So apparently this is the direction we have to proceed in. And I don't know whether that is a tree. Not enemies, those are trees. I can't see
this
the dish from here.
We see a bunker. We count two shooters.
I mean, that's not exactly the dish. That is an antenna, but I cannot see where the dish is. Probably closer at this point in time. Yeah, I can't see enemies right here. Maybe I should go ahead and start shooting already, huh? I mean, it looks a bit. Somebody else already decided to begin the action without me, so might as well, right? Enemy spotted? Of course, I'll probably shoot a little higher to actually tag them. Ooh, I didn't expect myself to be able to make that shot, but I did. And since we have the time limit on this mission, it's a pretty fresh change compared to the previous mission where, you know, everything had to be done on time. Yeah, one more person. I am on top of a shooting game today, which is like a pretty fresh change, to be honest. Pretty refreshing. Come on, stop running. Finally got him. Got this guy as well, and any more people? Two more people over here, and they are both looking at me. I think they're inside the bunkers over there. At least one of those guys is dead. Don't know what happened to the other guy there. Yeah, I think I'm looking straight at. Is that a statistic tree? That is not a guy. That needs to be killed. No need for killing those people over there. And suddenly there's like a deadly stillness. Indicative of a lack of enemies. No, I can't see somebody running towards me on the map. Actually, they're just running patrols. Nobody's running towards anyone. I just want to take things a little more cautiously as far as this bunker is concerned. But yeah, let's keep moving, I suppose. But this bunker is sort of what gives me a bit of a headache at this point, because, well, it's like I'm pretty exposed to it. It's the problem. There. Probably, I mean, there's somebody shooting at me probably from inside that bunker over there. I mean, I did see some. There he is. Now, the rest of the enemies seem to be unreachable. So, what I'll do instead of following the objective markers is go from on top of these mountains. Because, well, frankly, the objective markers here suck. So. Yeah, I'm just gonna go around them. I'm actually gonna have to sit to editing this video a lot because for some reason the mute button on my mic is not working. And well, I'm just gonna have to sit and edit all my drops out. My throat infection situation has actually gotten worse. Not that anybody asked, but yeah, it has. So I'm just gonna have to, you know, deal with it the old-fashioned way. Edit them out one by one throughout the entire length of the video. And I suppose it's not something that is too demanding, so to speak. I think that is an enemy. Yes, it was. And I think that. Somebody else is also shooting.
Charlie, Alpha Team is down.
Yeah. I mean, I pretty much expected them to be. Did not really expect them to be able to help much at all, but it would seem that they have actually helped quite a bit. And I don't know where they got shot from, which is basically what concerns me the most at this point. But there is one person over there that I can shoot and kill, and that guy said. It's funny how these guys die so dramatically, but at the same time I wouldn't really blame the game developers for making things epic. There's somebody in front of me, and I don't think that guy's inside the bunkers. I think that is him. Yes, yes, that is. I think that is another person in the city of Crete. I think it is a creep. Anyway, let me just proceed cautiously. Hopefully, I will not be having to. Oh, wait, there's still somebody here. That was not a person to kill. Everybody inside this bunker is dead. There's just one person somewhere down here in front of me. And, excuse me, I was trying to. Yeah, go from there. There are a few more people over there, but I suppose all we can do at this point is just proceed cautiously. Try not to get killed. Doing that can be usually pretty devastating. So I think there's another buddy of his somewhere over there, or so I suppose. Now, I usually dislike using the map to cheat like that, like this, but well, there's really no other way sometimes. And I'm sort of lucky that the other guy did not shoot in this encounter, because usually these guys are pretty damn accurate when they decide to be. Like, one bullet, like, they don't even give you enough time to shoot first. I mean, my personally, my reaction time is pretty slow, as is, but even apart from that, yeah, it becomes difficult to shoot these people. Now, I am looking in this general direction. I cannot see anybody over yonder. That does not mean there is nobody there, but let's just hope that they don't see me first and start shooting, because that would be a shame. There are definitely more people on top of that hill over there. That is a tree. I probably should not have stopped there. That seems like a dead guy. It is. Trying to keep my profile as low as possible. I don't know about Charlie team, but Alpha team is currently dead as can be, and I think this guy is still further. Yeah, I've been looking at the wrong place all this time, all this while. Let me just go ahead and I think, oh, that's not the guy. I'm just hoping that I don't die needlessly to this one guy, but I mean, we have to take him out anyway. There's really no other way around it. Huh. Now, one of the more peculiar things about this game is how it, well, that is a lot of people down there towards the bottom of the map there. But anyway, one of the more peculiar things about this game is how it, well, handles detection. Like, there's like a certain percentage of your body that must be visible before enemies are able to see you. And if you're prone especially, it's very difficult for other people to notice you, as well as notice about this game. And that's a lot of noticing all around. And I can see somebody, I can hear somebody shooting rather. I can't see anybody shooting, of course. And I don't know what happened to Charlie team, whether they are at all involved in this entire equation. That's one person dead. I suppose that might take care of a few troubling elements over there, but who knows. No, I do not think that took care of anyone at all. Or maybe it did. Yeah, that was a different
Charlie,
bunker.
Coming over the hill.
Roger Charlie, and speak of the devil, and here they are. There should be another bunker somewhere over here. Anyway, let's just try not to rush too much, but try not to be too cautious at the same time. Now, I can see a huge bunker complex with the satellite uplink dish on top of it, and honestly, yeah, I mean, we might as well just target it from here itself. I'm down to my last few bullets. Maybe I'll go a little closer before I begin targeting it. I just hope I don't get shot while I'm doing this. Not that I'm averse to having to retry this mission, because usually these missions take a few tries before we get them right. I think this should be close enough. I cannot really see any enemy inside. Pretty sure there are lots of them, but I cannot see any from inside. This, however, is probably the best spot for me to take out this satellite. And that apparently took out a lot of enemies as well.
Shooter on the ridge! We got one on the ridge!
Really?
Target destruction confirmed. Prepare for extraction.
Roger, ping 6. Now, while this is the case, should I just leave these guys be? There's like one more person right here, and I don't exactly want to drag this battle out. But, well. No, I cannot exactly see this guy, and that's pretty much what the problem is. Yep, dead. So anyway, let's just go ahead and proceed to the extraction point then. Extraction point is 421 meters away, and since...
Black Widow to Bravo, prepare for pickup.
Yeah, since this path is more or less clear, I'll just keep proceeding along this axis of advance, because there are like a fuck ton of enemies over there, and I don't want to go there, like at all, so might as well keep proceeding from this look, from, you know, this side of the hill. I mean, amazingly enough, we got this down on the first try itself, which is, well, a lot to ask for in Delta Force, and that is Charlie 1 and 2, not just Charlie 1 here. Yeah, that's Charlie 2. Good to see you, mates. How are you? Alpha team couldn't make it, sadly. Who the fuck? What the fuck are these guys doing? Yeah, that's on me. I probably should have been a little more careful with my advance. Yep, and now enemies are rushing towards us. Better be careful. Let me just go prone here. So that when they do show up, they don't exactly manage to take us out so easily. Two enemies here, two enemies dead. Three more enemies left, and I think they're just fighting the bunker complex over there. Now, I think there is another enemy near one of the bunkers over there that I need to be careful of. There's definitely one more enemy somewhere over there. I just don't know where, but somewhere over there. Hopefully they won't be too much of a problem. These guys, there's like one more enemy over there who could be a problem. And I'll keep on the lookout for him. Don't exactly want him to get lucky. Can't see him thus far. And I suppose that is good news in a sense. And even the bunker is out of view, which is excellent news in my book. What can't see me, can't shoot me dead, is what I always say. Never felt better to see you in my life, Black Widow. And goddamn, I got lucky in this mission. I mean, I got it. Oh no.
Bravo, your target is the dish. Take out the dish.
Now, at this juncture, I'm not really certain whether or not to, you know, cry over the fact that I lost the kill statistics, but anyway, I mean, the mission was clear. I got super lucky in this mission on two aspects. First one was how I could practically manage to clear it in the first go itself, and then there's also the fact that I got shot once, but I didn't die. And I literally got blindsided there, which was mostly my fault. I can't exactly rely on the... my allied forces in this game, that is completely like on me. So that is a lesson that I've learned the hard way around, having to rely on them time and again throughout the game. But anyway, this was either a very straightforward mission, which I think it was, and I also got lucky playing it. So if not the first try, I think I probably would have been able to do it in the second try itself. So moving on, good job Bravo team. The destruction of the satellite, I think, leaves enemy commanders with no way to contact supporters of the island. Isolated, they have to rely on their resources at hand, which are rapidly dwindling. Plans are currently underway to pick up the tempo of our offensive operations. Good, good job, finally, we're getting somewhere. Bravo team, your main priorities are now a downed air crew rescue and the destruction of their covert operation space, if it is still operational. We are still losing helicopters on a regular basis due to the extreme large numbers of man-portable anti-air missiles, or in other words, RPGs. Maybe bazookas, who knows, I can't speak to the instruments of these rebel forces, but typically it's RPGs because they're cheap to acquire, but who knows, maybe these guys could be, might have been very well financially backed. After all, they've got tactical nuclear warheads. But yeah, I suppose, and they've got bunkers, like elaborate bunkers in the attack helicopters, but yeah, could be RPGs as well, you never know. As enemy patrols are eliminating our downed air crews, instead of capturing them, it is imperative that we get to them first. Is it going to be another one of those retrieval missions which are on a timer? I mean, let's see, yes, it has not unlocked any further missions. This is Operation Whirlwind for now, and I think Fallen Angels was supposed to be unlocked after Operation Snowblind, maybe? But, or maybe there's yet another rescue operation like that. Because Fallen Angels was... it was stressful to say the least. Anyway, this video is not about Fallen Angels, it is about Operation Snowblind, and this mission was very easy. Next up, we have Whirlwind. Now, destroy an enemy outpost designated objective castle, and this seems like a standard eliminate everybody mission. So, let's hope it will go as well as, you know, Operation Snowblind went. And with that, we have completed 6 missions out of I don't know how many of the Novaya Zemlya campaign. I still don't know, is it Novaya Zemlya or is it Novaya Zemlya? Because whenever I type Novaya, it autocorrects to Novaya. So, I don't know, maybe the spelling changed over the past few years. That stuff happens. So, anyway, are we getting off topic here? Well, thank you for tuning in today. The next time we come around, we'll be tackling Objective Whirlwind and hopefully capturing it as well. Of course, we will capture it. I'm not going to give up until we do. So, yeah, that's the topic for the next video. As for today, thank you for watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell to all things.